Hi, my name is Michelle Embleton, and today we're going to look at what is an antral follicle count. An antral follicle count is a non-invasive technique which is used to study a woman's ovarian reserve. A woman's ovarian reserve is a measure of how many eggs a woman has available at any given moment in her life. This procedure is conducted routinely in assisted reproduction centres and is useful not only if you are looking at assisted reproductive treatments, but also to give you an idea of your fertility for the future if you are thinking of postponing motherhood. Results of the antral follicle count are usually taken in conjunction with hormonal tests such as AMH hormone, and this can give us a good indication of what a woman's ovarian reserve is. So in this video, I want to talk about how many eggs does a woman have throughout her life, what is an antral follicle, and how is an antral follicle count performed. Then we'll have a look at some of the most frequently asked questions from our users and answer them for you. The ovaries have a certain number of eggs at birth, and this is usually around 1 to 2 million eggs. A woman is born with all of the eggs she will ever have throughout her life. When a woman reaches puberty, the number of eggs will have been reduced to approximately 400,000 to 500,000. With the onset of the menstrual cycle at puberty, an egg is released every month in menstruation, but not one egg is developing at any one time. In reality, several eggs develop at once until one becomes the egg which ends up being ovulated. The rest of the eggs will then be lost in a process known as atresia. In this way, the number of oocytes is gradually depleted over the years until the woman reaches the age of menopause. As the number of eggs a woman had is constantly decreasing, when a woman gets to around the age of 35, we see that the ovarian reserve starts to get depleted more and more rapidly. From the age of about 40 onwards, egg reserve is usually very low. And indeed, the quality of the eggs at this age tends to be lower as well due to accumulated genetic damage, which is normal and natural over the years. Although the main factor affecting your ovarian reserve is your age, there are some women who have a low ovarian reserve at a younger age. As a result, it is always useful to know what your ovarian reserve is at any age. Antral follicles are the ovarian follicles that still contain an immature egg inside them. However, these follicles are at a developmental stage that they are sensitive to follicle-stimulating hormone. As such, these antral follicles may develop into pre-ovulatory follicles. From these antral follicles, only one will develop each month to then release the mature egg in ovulation. Antral follicles are characterized by having something in them called an antrum, and this is a fluid-filled cavity within the antral follicle. This allows antral follicles to be visualized in an ultrasound examination, and indeed they can be of 1 to 2 millimeters in diameter. So using an ultrasound, the specialist can visualize the antral follicles and actually count them. The antral follicle count is a procedure which is used to measure a woman's ovarian reserve, and it is usually performed during between days 2 and 4 of the menstrual cycle in the early follicular phase. The gynecologist will use a transvaginal ultrasound in which to perform the antral follicle count, and in this way the procedure is painless and non-invasive. In general, the antral follicle count is considered to be normal when the gynecologist can count between 5 and 10 antral follicles in each ovary. A low ovarian reserve would be indicated when less than 5 antral follicles are counted in each ovary, and conversely, a high ovarian reserve would be when the specialist has counted more than 10 antral follicles in each ovary. In polycystic ovaries, you can see often more than 12 or 13 antral follicles developing, and they often look like a string of pearls on the ultrasound. Knowing the state of your ovarian reserve can help you make decisions on how and when to become a mother. For example, if you are a young woman and you know you want to delay motherhood until later in life, it's a good idea to get your ovarian reserve checked. This could be by antral follicle count and looking at your AMH hormone. And that way, if you have a low ovarian reserve at an early age, you can look at fertility preservation to freeze your oocytes for later use in life. If your ovarian reserve is low, this is where assisted reproduction techniques can come in to help, and you may be able to achieve parenthood through techniques such as IVF. Knowing your antral follicle count not only gives you an idea of ovarian reserve, but it also helps the specialist in an IVF treatment to know how the ovary will respond to the ovarian stimulation. The higher the antral follicle count, the more oocytes the specialist can expect to obtain during the egg retrieval process. If you have a very high antral follicle count, your specialist may want to perform the ovarian stimulation using certain drugs that limit the risks of ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome, whereby the ovaries have an excessive response to the hormonal medication that is being used. By knowing your antral follicle count, it helps the specialist to tailor your treatment to suit your needs. Now I want to have a look at some of the most frequently asked questions from our users and answer them for you. Is the antral follicle count a good predictor of the ovarian reserve? Yes, the antral follicle count is a good predictor of your ovarian reserve. However, the number of antral follicles observed can vary from cycle to cycle. And as your specialist is counting these from a transvaginal ultrasound, it is also observer dependent. In reality, the antral follicle count is used in conjunction with a hormonal analysis, such as anti-Müllerian hormone or AMH, and we look at these factors together to give an overall idea of what the ovarian reserve is. Can I have an antral follicle count at any time? Well, really, this question could be interpreted in two ways. The first is, can I have an antral follicle count at any time in my menstrual cycle? The AFC count will be performed between days 2 and 4 of your menstrual cycle during the follicular phase. Consider this question to be, at what age should I have an AFC count? Any age is the answer. If you are a younger woman and you know you're going to postpone your maternity till later in life, for example, you want to concentrate on your career first and think, I want to have my children in my late 30s, it's not a bad idea to have an antral follicle count performed and perhaps an AMH test to get an idea of your ovarian reserve. That way, if there looks that like there may be any fertility issues as you get older, you can take the measurements now and preserve your fertility for later in life. And if necessary, it's a way of becoming your own egg donor for the future. We'd like to hear about your experiences, so please leave a comment below. And if you've enjoyed the video and found it useful, don't forget to click like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos. And I would like to remind you that, as always, in the description below, I leave you with a link to an article all about the antral follicle count.